What's the mom's name?
Letitia Davis.
Letitia Davis.
This is ongoing. Apparently she leaves every other day. Like
this is supposed to be, this is an ongoing issue with leaving the 15-year-old in charge of the two younger ones, the 3-year-old and the 1-year-old. She done tried to call the cell phone a couple of times, and the only way to get a hold of dad is over TikTok. Yeah.
If y'all make me stay here, y'all gonna stay here too.
We won't make you stay here, okay?
But just I'm not
work.
Staying here.
I got you. We just work with us.
Well, we're at the residence,
we'll see
man.
See what we can do for you, okay? Just give us a little time. We gotta make some phone calls and stuff.
Hey, what's your mom's cell phone number?
It's okay.
So how long has she been gone?
Right now.
Since this morning? Yep.
I called and said that she would, to get y'all to come. I just told them she was gone since last night, but it's not actually what happened. I called y'all because, yeah, I didn't feel safe here. I don't feel safe here. And she do this every single night.
So where did she go?
With her boyfriend. She got multiple men, I think. I don't know. She got messed with 5 dudes. And I don't feel safe here. And we be fighting. We fight.
Huh?
Who'd you talk to?
Lauren.
Yeah.
She said to call that number.
We fight all the time.
You said the central heat and the central air is not working?
No.
How long has it not been working?
Since yesterday. I'm 15 years old and I should choose where I want to stay. And I should stay with my father.
Is there
I know where he stay and I know where he at.
Is there there's another kid that's right?
Aren't yeah, I got now? 2 more brothers. They're with their grandma right now. They're with their grandma.
Okay.
Is there
a way that you can contact grandma?
No, she I don't know her number.
Police responded to the call that day and immediately contacted the Department of Human Services, who tried to reach the mother. DHS had previously visited the home and attempted to contact Davis, but each and every time she either hung up the phone or pretended to speak a different language. Given the situation, DHS arranged for the children to be placed in the care of their father, who stated that he had no knowledge of her whereabouts or whether she had planned to return.
Hello?
Hey, is this Timothy? Hey, Timmy, this is Corporal Long Tillman from the police department.
I'm sorry, just give me 1 sec.
Hello? Hey, this is Corporal Long of Town of Truman Police Department.
Yes, sir.
So I'm with your daughter and your son.
Okay.
And the mother has left them pretty much abandoned at the residence here in Truman.
Yeah.
And the 15-year-old is taking care of the 1-year-old and the 3-year-old right now. I have DHS on the way, coming to investigate what's going on.
Well, I thought Mom was at home.
No, Mom hasn't been home all day today. Mom hasn't been home since this morning? Yeah, she hasn't been home since this morning. According to your daughter. Yeah, your daughter's been watching the 1-year-old and 3-year-old by herself.
Okay.
Yeah, you want to talk to her?
Do I need to come and get them?
You want to talk? I mean, DHS is involved now, and which is, I mean, if there's a possibility that you can start heading this way, because
yes.
I would recommend you start heading this way so you can actually talk to DHS. To see what's going on.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Pretty serious matter, so. Yeah, do you want to talk to your daughter? Yeah, she is.
Later that night, shortly after the children were taken away, Letitia Davis returned home and would be promptly taken into custody by the police. The report says the teenager indicated her mother had done this several times before and was relieved to finally have had help. Davis now faces three counts of endangering the welfare of a minor.